the day, lying down and dreaming of a way to catch up. Today I am going to be talking about Fate the Winx Club. Sorry, I couldn't say that with a straight face. But yeah, today I'm going to be talking about the Fate Winx Club that has come to Netflix. I think it aired Friday. I started watching it yesterday or the night before, but I basically binge watched it all within like a day, technically. And I have a lot to say about it, not too much. I'm not going to go too much into it, but yes, there are spoilers for the show, just so y'all know, so you don't come into this thinking there will be, but I will be talking about spoilers. But yeah, let's get to it. The first thing I want to talk about, and this is something I really want to talk about, is the fact that they switched out two characters and added two new characters. So in the original Winx, we had Flora and Tecna, and they removed those two characters from the show. And they replaced Terra and this character named Beatrix, I believe, into the show. But they still have Bloom, of course, Aisha, Stella, and Musa. And I want to get to that also about Musa. So in the show, Musa is, she looks Asian American, at least she looks Asian. And in the TV show, I don't really want to comment on this actor's race, because I try to look it up. It doesn't really say where she, like, I know she's from Britain, but I don't know like her full background. I don't think she is half Asian. She might be half like she might be like British, like a Latino or something. I'm not sure, but I feel like she would have been better as Flora to give other Asian Americans or British Asians a chance to, you know, try out for the role of Musa, because Musa does look Asian. So give that Asian actor a chance, no matter where they come from, a chance to at least, I don't know, you know, portray that character, because there are more Asian American, you know, Asian British too, actors who are coming to light, and Asian, you know, wherever you're from, coming to light to be in more movies, which is great, because we need more diversity for sure. And I don't think Asians are actually getting that recognition, and it's really, really sad that they're not. I just feel like just a disclaimer real quick. I am not bashing these actors in any way. I am just, my personal opinion is that I feel like they could have opened this up for more, you know, opportunity and more roles and more diversity for more actors to come forward. Even though the actor for Musa, she's really, you know, she's really pretty, I feel like she would have been a better fit for Flora. So, no offense to the actress, I just feel like she would have been better for Flora, and they actually get an Asian actor to be Musa, which would have been awesome to see. And also, like I said, they took out Tecna, and Tecna, I'm not saying who's replacing who, but there's a new character. Oh, okay, probably Terra is taking over Tecna's spot. So Terra is this new character they put in. She's an earth fairy. She is white. And sorry, it's laughing too hard. But I have no issue, like I said, I have no issues with the actors or actresses in the show. But it's like, I felt like if they wanted to add a new character like Terra, I like Terra's character. I think she's very sweet, very humble, and people think she's naive. And I just feel like if they were going to add a new character, go ahead and add a new character, because they're out of school. They're going to meet new characters anyway, new friends, except friends like in their friend group. So they could have had Terra as just like an extra fairy, like a friend like that they meet, like an ally, but still had Tecna. I don't understand why they did that. And I'm like, and the thing is, it's frustrating because it's like, they're all like, oh, well, we added a dark-skinned character who's darker than a paper bag for Aisha. Y'all should be happy. Yes, thank you for adding one dark-skinned character who's darker than a paper bag. Thank you for that. Well, everybody is lighter than a paper bag. Thank you for adding that character. Thank you. And the actress is beautiful, and I love Aisha, and I think she's the best part of the show. I'll get to that in a sec, but I do think she's the best part of the show, and I'm really happy that they did cast this actress, and she's dark skin and beautiful. Like, I am just so happy they did that, but still, that I'm still mad. So, like I said, I binge-watched this show I think I watched one episode the night before, and then I finished all the episodes today. So, if they did not call the show Winx Club, and it was basing it off the Winx Club, I think I would have liked it more, because I do like these kind of cringy young adult TV show kind of darkness, like, you know, Sabrina and stuff like that, like in Riverdale. But it's like, I do like those shows, and those are like my guilty pleasure shows, but they called us the Winx Club, and I have an issue with that, the fact that they called it the Winx Club. And if they didn't call it the Winx Club but something else, I would have loved the show. Like, oh, the show is so good, so trash. But the fact that they're calling it the Winx Club, I have an issue with that. I really, really do. And if they didn't call it that, I would have been fine with it. I would have been totally fine with them not calling it the Winx Club, but they are. So they made it a little bit darker than the animated show. They kind of made it like Sabrina of Riverdale. Like, it's definitely darker. And honestly, I don't like that. And it's, I don't think any of the fans, people my age, older, or even a little bit younger, who have watched the Winx show growing up, we don't like that. I wanted sparkles. That's why I'm wearing so much glitter. Like, I wanted sparkles. I wanted glitter. I wanted shine. I wanted, like, little cheesiness, not darkness. Like, oh, I'm so blooms all like, oh, I'm so edgy. Like, I don't want that. That's not what I wanted. I wanted something that wasn't dark. We don't need all these shows being remade or coming to life to be dark. I wanted, girls don't always want the dark stuff. We like the dark emo stuff. We like that shit. But we also like the glitter, the glamour, the pink, the sparkles. We all love that stuff. Like, we really do. Like, we all love that stuff. And I talked to my friends about that. We wanted the glitter. We wanted all of that and the cheesiness. So we wanted that. So why couldn't they just give it to us? They didn't have to make the show dark. They really didn't. Let me get to the boys. So there's, I don't even know. Okay, first off, I swear there was a guy named Brandon in the original show. I don't even think he's in the show. If he is, I totally missed it. Or they replaced him with, like, Sam. Don't know. But Sky and Riven. Okay. We gotta talk about Sky first, then I'm gonna get to Riven. So Sky, I hate it. Like, the beginning of the show, I hated it. Like, the first 5 minutes, the first 10 minutes at least, when she gets to the school, she's, like, walking through, like, I'm not like other girls. Haha, red hair. New girl at school. Oh my god, I'm so different. Everybody else has an accent, but I'm American. She is just so, no offense to the actress, but, like, the writing, it was so bad. Like, the first, it gets better throughout the episodes, but the first episode, I was cringing. It was so bad. She was just like, I'm not like other girls. Walking, looking around, see if anybody's looking at her. Like, I'm new here. And then Skye's like, whoa, I never seen that girl before. She's not like other girls. There's something, like, I don't know, different about her. She's just like any other white girl. Like, what do you mean different about her? She doesn't have an accent, but I wanted to slap. I wanted to slap them for that, because I was like, so stupid, it's so cringy. I'm like, well, whatever. She's not like other girls, bro. Shut up. Like, cringy. But I do, throughout the episodes, I feel like Sky and Bloom's relationship was a little rushed. I do like Sky, but I just feel like it was a little rushed, and I wish that, like, there wasn't so much tension with them early on. I felt like it wasn't warranted. That was kind of dumb, but whatever. But I don't hate him. I don't hate him as a character. I really don't. But let's get to Riven. Whew, the bad boy. I don't like him. I don't like his character, and I don't care if he redeems himself. I don't like him. I really don't like him. I don't like him at all. I think there is a character that comes and I'm so sorry. And here is where the problem comes. There is a character who's a first year. He's a light skin you know, black kid. I don't know if he's half-half, whatever. But he's a person of color. And he, I think he might be bisexual. Or, you know, he might be bisexual, asexual, whatever. Doesn't matter what his sexuality is. But he is the, he, you know, he's open for, he doesn't care. Or pansexual, but he doesn't care if he, you know, he's attracted to guys and girls. Like, he's attracted to anyone, but in different ways. I'm not really familiar with all the sexualities, but I know he, that's just who he is. And I think that's awesome. But Ruben kind of bullies him, and I don't like that. Like, he makes comments throughout the show that I don't like. A little homophobic. I don't like it. It makes me really uncomfortable. Because there's this one part where, I think his name's Dane. Dane, like, you never do this. He, like, one of his old Instagram pictures. I'm like, bro, you don't do that. And he's like, Riven, like, call him out for it. He's like, yeah, this is, like, really weird. Like, he knows. He's like, yeah, I think you're hot. Like, stop making fun of him. I don't know. Just, like, I don't want to go too much into it. But basically, it made me really uncomfortable with how Riven acted. He tried to be the bad boy. Oh, it's smoking. Yeah, bro. Making homophobic comments and being really, like, passive aggressive. And it's like, so are you a bisexual? Like, what is your sexuality? I was hoping that he would just fall for this guy instead of being so homophobic. But whatever, we'll see in the second season. I just don't like it. I really don't. I just don't like Riven's character, and I think he is a problematic person and a character, and I just don't like some of the comments he made. I just thought it wasn't necessary for the show to show what a bad boy he is. I don't like that stereotype, and it needs to end. Like, it was kind of gross. But yeah. Right, so I had to look it up because I was like, this was bothering me and I don't want to contradict myself. But basically, this character Beatrix is a blend of the villainous trio, the Trix, into one character. That's what they did. That's what this is. I don't like that. I didn't realize that that's what they were doing. I was waiting for the Trix to show up, but no, it was just that one character, Beatrix. Yeah, also, I would like to point out, because I also saw it in an article that I was reading, I think it was like the New York Post, I'm not sure, but basically they were saying that, I totally missed this, but in the show, Tara mentions her cousin Flora. So are we going to see Flora in the second season? Because if so, I would love that. Also, is Flora cousin going to be brown skin? Because Tara is white. So I really hope, well, she is, you know, light brown skin. So I really hope, like, her cousin, you know, she better be brown skin and we better see her in the second season. I just really hope. But I totally missed that in the show where she was like, oh, my cousin Flora. I don't want to mention I want the character. But yeah. But back to Beatrix. So Beatrix basically, oh my god. It just dawned on me that Beatrix, the Trix, I'm a scream. That's cool that they did that, but I don't like this character. I think she's problematic. First off, she's a first year, so I think she's like 16. Second of all, she hooks up with Riven multiple times and they're like dating and they're gross and they're a toxic couple together. I hate it. She's trying to break into the Miss Dowling's whatever office, and the first thing she says to him to get him to help her is like, I'm your guy, I'm hot. And I'm like, no, you're not. You're not hot, but okay, girl. Like, it was just so cringy and so stupid. I'm like, I don't like you. I don't like this character. I think she's problematic. If she didn't, there are some scenes, if they take them out, I would have liked her, because it's like, I was like, okay, I kind of know where you're coming from. Like, I kind of know where you're coming from. I really do. But I don't like her. I really don't. I don't like her. I think she's problematic also. And a little, maybe she's homophobic too, because there's something else that happens later on that she's like, I didn't do that. I'm like, I don't know. You're kind of homophobic, girl. Like, I don't like her. I don't like this character, like, at all. I kind of liked her towards the end, but I'm like, I don't know. If they'd taken out a few couple scenes, I would have liked her more. But I really don't like her. I thought she was problematic from the start. I was like, No, and cringy, so. Okay, we also need to talk about Stella, how they changed her personality, because I don't remember her being, I know the girls fought, you know, there's always drama with girl groups sometimes, but it's like, I don't remember her being
a bitch.
Damn!
Because she was really mean. She is just a stuck-up bee. Sorry, she's just so stuck up. She's just mean. She's just a mean girl. And she redeems herself at the end. But I don't like that. I don't like how she's mean. I didn't like that from the start. Basically, you know, of course, Guy is flirting with Bloom, and Bloom's, you know, and of course, Stella gets jealous, et cetera, et cetera. She's like, oh, you're homesick? Let me give you my ring and give it to you so you can go back to that first world to see your parents because you're so homesick. And she lets her go in the forest by herself where she's attacked by a burn one, et cetera, et cetera. And then Bloom loses the ring, and then it's all like, it's your fault. You gotta help me go. No, it's not her fault. You sent, like, I don't, she's toxic and I don't like her. And I don't like how anybody calls her out. I really don't like that. And it's just like, I'm sitting there and I'm like, y'all say something to her, especially Sky was standing right next to her and then runs off after Bloom after and like one scene, like, I'm sorry, her person. No, don't apologize. Call out your friends for being toxic. She is a mean girl. Like, she's mean and I don't like that. I was like, Stella's not supposed to be mean. I don't like this. She's a bully. She does redeem herself after because you get to find out that her mom is because of her mom. Like, I get it. Your mom's a bee to you at home and you are princess, etc. Like, I totally get that. But when you have a toxic parent, you can, and you have some, like, non-toxic people around you in your friend group, you can decide whether you can be a good friend or a bad friend or a good person or a bad person. You can decide that. Stop blaming, like, oh, you know how my mom is. I don't care how your mom is. I don't care. It's like your mom being racist and you're like, this is why I'm racist. No, racism is taught and you can choose whether not to be racist or to be racist. It is taught. So you don't have to be mean. And I don't like the whole we're supposed to feel bad for her because her mom doesn't matter. You know that you're being a horrible person. So you should take responsibility for that. I'm so sick of seeing that in teen shows. It's not a good lesson. It's like, it's not a good lesson to teach teenage kids. Like, oh, she's just acting like a bitch because her mom is a bitch. No, you can choose not to be a bitch or not. Like, you know what I'm saying? I do want to talk about Aisha for a sec because I think Aisha is the best part of the show. Not only is she played by somebody who's darker than a paper bag, she is amazing. Her character is amazing and she's the best part of the show. And she is best girl. She is such a good friend. There's something she does, like, I think wasn't the last episode, and she basically, they're trying to release I forget her name, but they're trying to release somebody who was locked up for doing something bad, and she was like, it's not a good idea, we shouldn't be doing this, so she doesn't join them, but she rats them out to the I can't even say it, but, like, the headmistress, whatever, to, like, be like, hey, this is what they're doing. And they're like, wow. And Stella's all mean to her, like, wow, way to be a rat. I'm like, a rat? You guys just released this person who's evil. When you watch the season finale, you're gonna be like, no, Aisha was literally trying to protect the school and her friends. She knew it wasn't a good idea to release somebody. And she knew Bloom was too stupid not to release her. Aisha was the best part of the show because when Bloom is acting like an edgy teenager, like, oh, I have so much going on and I did this. Aisha's over here like, we all go through shit. We all go through shit. It's not just you, honey. We all go through it, but we can't dwell on the past. We gotta get better. And she even tells Bloom, I don't like how you're learning how to control your powers. She even tries to help Bloom to spy on the headmistress. Like, are you kidding me? Aisha's like the best part of the show. I love her character. She's so great. And there was like no romance for her. It really made me mad. But like, she is so great and she's such a great character. And I really liked also Muse's character. I really liked her character, even though I wish she was played by an Asian actor. I really did like her character. I really did. She wasn't like trying to be edgy or anything, but in the beginning, you think she's trying to be edgy, but once, like, you know, her mind, she's a mind fairy, and her mind powers, you get it. Like, she has all these emotions coming to her. There's so much she has to deal with that she just wants her own emotions, and I respect that. Like, Tara was really annoying in the beginning, I swear to God, but, like, I respect that. And also, Misa has this romance with the, Tara's brother, Sam, and it's the cutest thing on earth, and I felt like it was really authentic, and it was, like, kind of a slow burn because he can walk through walls and but she can sense him, so she's like, she knows he's there. I thought that was really cute how their romance turned out, and it didn't feel forced like Sky and Bloom. So yeah, all right, let me sum up this video because it's really long. So I didn't really talk about the plot because that's not what I wanted to talk about. I wanted to talk about what they should have done differently and the characters, etc., etc. The plot was like, eh, it was okay, but there's not much I really want to talk about the plot. But overall, I need to end this video because, like I said, it's too long. Overall, if they didn't call the show The Winx Club, I think I would have liked it better if they didn't call it The Winx Club, if they called it something else. And I wish that there was preppy, pretty, bratty, glitter, you know what I mean? I just wish they did that because girls want that too. We don't need stuff like Riverdale and Sabrina. We don't need everything to be dark. I want to see like glitter, like cheesiness. Like that's what I wanted to see. And I didn't get that. Another thing is them taking out Tecna and Flora. And also, it's just also, I had to cut it off, sorry. But it's also the fact that they could have just like casted more people of color. Like Aisha's actress, like I said a million times, is beautiful, and she's darker than a paper bag, which we don't see often in TV shows for main characters, and I think she's a great character, but I feel like they could have done more diversity in the show and they didn't do it. I feel like they could have just stuck with all the characters because these characters are really important to the show. I feel like they didn't have to make it dark and make Bloom really annoying and like, I'm so edgy, I'm not like other girls. I feel like they didn't need to make Ribbon a little homophobic and annoying and bad boy. I didn't like that. I really just didn't like that. And I'm going to watch the second season when it comes out. Because let's see what they do with that. And if they add Flora and Tecna later on, that would be awesome. And I would love that. And maybe kill off the other characters I don't like. Them forming the Trix into Beatrix. Okay, whatever. That's really smart because her name's Beatrix. But she was really annoying and I didn't like her. Until maybe like that last episode. There's so much they could have done with this, and this show is really dear to my heart because I watched this, I think it was like Channel 4. I think it was after the Sonic show, but it was like on Channel 4. Oh, I forgot what it was called. The name was like Warner Brothers. I forget what the name was, like the, you know, like Toonami. Like I forget what like the name was for the opening, but I remember, maybe it was Jetix, I don't remember, but like, I just remember watching it as a kid and on Channel 4 after, I think, the Sonic show, like I said. This show is really dear to my heart, so it's really, it sucks that this is what they did with it, to make it more Riverdale, darkness. That's not what we wanted, but okay. And I really hope in the second season there is more diversity. I kind of like how it ended and how the story is going to further. And there was more colorful clothing, I feel like, in the end. But I really hope this doesn't get canceled like they always do with Netflix shows, unfortunately. They always get the shows canceled. So I just really hope that the show, they add the characters that we want to see, especially Tecna and Flora. And I hope they add more diversity to the characters instead of making a gay black character where they make homophobic, like he was just problematic. But overall, I did like the show. I would just wish it was what we wanted. But will I watch the second season? Yeah, I might as well. Like I like trash shows. Like it's trash. Like I watched it so my friends didn't have to. That's basically the only reason why I watched it. I was like, oh, I can just tell them what happened. But yeah, I'm really disappointed, but I'm gonna watch the second season, so, because trash. But yeah, thanks guys for watching this video. Sorry it's so long, but it's just something I wanted to talk about. And a friend suggested it too. She's like, when are you gonna make a YouTube video about it? I'm like, I guess I will. But yeah, thank you for watching, and bye.